Welcome to this gentle chair yoga sequence. My name is Leah Wilson Fellis, and I will be your guide for the next 30 minutes or so. We'll begin in a chair. A folding chair works. Any chair without an arm. So this is just a typical folding chair. And if you do have some challenge with balance, I would suggest doing this practice either with a wall next to you, a kitchen countertop, or perhaps another folding chair for balance. So we'll begin seated in our chair with our feet flat on the ground and our back resting on the flat back of the chair. You can start with your hands flat or palms face up, or one palm up and one palm down. The choice is yours. And as we begin, we'll start by just sitting up as tall as possible, grounding down through the soles of the feet, feeling each of the pads of the toes melting into the floor. Feel your sits bones sitting firmly in your chair, and your mid-back resting right up against the flat surface of the back of the chair. Notice if there's any tension in your face or your shoulders, in your arms, in your back. Just bringing your awareness to the whole body now. The feet planted, the knees, the hips, the shoulders and spine, the elbows and wrists, the neck and the jaw. Take a couple deep breaths as you just bring awareness to your body today. We'll begin creating some movement with our breath. So if you'd like, you can keep your eyes closed or gently flutter them open. The palms will face up towards the ceiling. And as you inhale, sweep your fingertips outward and up towards the ceiling, lengthening your arms up to the sky. Exhale and let your palms face down as you rake the air out in front of you. Let's do it two more times, inhaling to lift. Exhaling to float back down. One more. This time, sweep your hands out to the side. Inhale, reach your arms, circling them up and around your body so that your fingertips might come together. Maybe they don't. And then exhale and float your hands back down to the sides of the chair. Inhale, palms face up as you rotate and swing the arms out and up as high as they go. Exhale, palms face down as you float back down. Last time, just like that, breathing in and lifting up. Breathing out and floating down. Continue to reach your right fingertips down towards the floor as you sweep your left hand up towards the ceiling. And we're just going to slide, sliding the right fingertips a bit closer towards the floor as your left hand reaches up to the ceiling or over your head. Take a big breath here. Inhale and bring yourself back up to center. Feel how you've stretched that left side body. The right hand will sweep up to the ceiling as the left hand sweeps down and tries to reach down towards the floor. Feel the right side of your body lengthening from your hip bone to your underarm. And take a deep breath. Take another one. Inhale and bring yourself back up to center and float yourself back to center seated. We'll call this seated mountain pose. From here, we'll sweep both hands out and up overhead towards the sky. Start to reach them forward so that the belly starts to reach towards the thighs. The hands can reach either on the outside of the legs with your legs closer together, or if that's a little bit too much stretch for you, maybe you separate your feet a bit wider and your hands reach through the legs. So even if your hands do not touch the floor, it might be nice or handy to have a yoga block close by so that you can reach for your yoga block instead of the floor. So we'll take a couple breaths in whichever posture you have chosen. Either legs a bit wider, feeling a little bit of inner thigh. Maybe your legs are a bit closer together, and you're feeling more low back. Start to bow your head, chin to chest, so that you're letting go of the neck. Begin to roll back up, slowly inhaling. We'll do a couple postures here seated. So we'll start with a couple lower body postures, and then we'll move on to upper body postures. So let's stretch our hamstring, the backs of the legs. I'll have you extend your right leg out, and you might have to scooch to the edge of your chair so that the back of your leg doesn't hit the back of the chair and hurt. So our right leg is now lengthened out with our left foot flat. Take a big inhale, sweep up for the sky, and start to reach for your right knee. Maybe you slide down for your right shin. Maybe you start to slide to your ankle, or maybe you can reach your toes. Wherever you are, start to let go of your head, your neck, bowing down, bowing forward. And take three deep breaths as you hold your hamstring stretch. Beautiful. Begin to slide your hands back up to your right knee. Bring your right leg back to a bent position, sitting on the edge of your chair. Left leg will lengthen straight out, toes lifted, heel on the floor. Sweep your hands up to the ceiling, lengthening through the whole body, and start to fold forward, reaching for your left knee. Begin to slide down to your left shin, always adjusting on the chair if you need to find a more comfortable position for yourself. Perhaps you slide down to the ankle, or you can reach for your big toe. Wherever you are on this side, bow your head, chin to chest, and find your breath. Begin to slide back up to center. Slide your left foot back to the seated posture so that you're in a tall seated mountain pose. We're going to aim to work our inner thigh. So extend your right leg back out where it was, and then we're going to try to take our leg out to an angle off the edge of the chair. If it helps you, you can let your left knee drop out to the side. Sweep your arms out to a T. Start to rotate so that your heart or your sternum faces your left thigh. Begin to lean over, reaching for your right shin with your right hand. Left hand reaches up. So not only am I feeling my right inner thigh, but I'm also feeling my left side body. Start to get your head involved by leaning your head towards the right. Relax your right shoulder and breathe. Inhale and bring yourself back up to center. Relax your arms. Bring the legs back to center for our seated mountain pose. We'll try it on the other side. So our left leg will extend out in front. Adjust your seat on the chair. Slide your leg out to the outer edge of the chair. Again, you might have to adjust the hips or where you're seated on the chair. Let your right knee maybe drop out to the side. Or maybe that doesn't serve your knee and it feels better to keep it straight. So you have to figure out what works best for you. We'll open our arms like a T. Rotate to the right so that your heart faces towards your right knee. And start to tilt towards the left. Left hand drops down to the left knee or the left shin as the right hand reaches up. Relax the left shoulder. Let your head lean to the left. Breathe. Inhale and fan your way back to center, relaxing the right arm, bringing the legs back to seated mountain pose. Our next posture will be working up into the hips. So we'll take our right leg and either cross the outer ankle over the left thigh or knee. If this is not available for you, it could be more like your calf, or you could cross your legs over completely. So the choice is yours. I prefer a figure four. So your knee might not be as open or at this angle as mine is. We'll sit up nice and tall. Reach your arms forward and start to lean forward, resting your forearms down on this kind of straight aspect of your shin, your lower leg. If your leg, your right leg is crossed over your left, then the arms are going to reach forward. Maybe you hug around your knees until you find a stretch, until you feel a stretch. It doesn't need to hurt. Remember that a stretch should feel good. You can get your neck involved here by rolling over, rounding over, and dropping your chin towards your chest. One more deep breath here, in through your nose and out through your nose. Staying in whatever position you have chosen, so figure four, or leg crossed over, you will take your left hand to the outside of your right knee or thigh. Take your right hand to the outside of the chair or the back of the chair. Sit up tall and add a twist. Inhale. And exhale to add just a little bit more twist. Maybe look over your right shoulder. Last breath. Come back to center. Take your right leg back down to the floor so that you're in a seated mountain pose. Take your left hand across your knees. Start to reach that right hand down to the outside of your right ankle. Sweep your right hand out. Sweep it up as high as you can go. Some people can go all the way. Some people only go halfway. So find the right angle for your body, trying to spiral from your heart center. Don't forget to breathe. And we'll release, coming back to center. Other side. So we will pick up our left foot and either cross the outer left ankle over the top of the right knee, or slide the leg over to your ability. So maybe it's halfway, maybe you go all the way over and cross the leg. Wherever you are, I want you to sit up tall. Shoulders back and down. Reach your arms out and start to round over, reaching towards your knees, reaching your chest towards your knees until you feel a stretch. Remember, if it hurts, back up just a little bit so that it does not hurt. We want our stretches to feel good. Take one more deep breath while you're here in this hip opening posture, breathing in through the nose and out through the nose, controlling the breath. Beautiful. Bring yourself back up to center. Stay in whichever position you are in. So on this side, I will demonstrate with the more beginner posture, with the leg crossed all the way over. The right hand comes to the outside of the left knee. The left hand comes to the outside, the almost leg of the chair, or the back edge of the chair, whatever is available for you. Sit up tall, ground through your sits bones and through your right foot. Exhale, add a twist. Inhale, sit up tall again. Exhale, add a twist. One more breath. Begin to unwind, coming back to center, unhooking that left leg, and coming back to seated mountain pose. Take your right hand and cross it over the knees, over the lap. Begin to round over, reaching your left fingertips down for the outside of your left foot or outer ankle. Start to sweep that hand out towards the wall, up towards the corner, or even up towards the ceiling, whatever is available to you. And you might gaze up at your left hand. Breathe. Last breath. As you exhale, round back over, sweeping the hand back down, and find your way back up. Hands on the knees, shoulders back, lean the belly forward to the thighs. Exhale, round your back, look down at your belly button. Inhale, open your chest, it's cow pose. Exhale, round your back, it's cat pose. Last time. Come back to center. Open your arms, inhale, squeeze the chest open by bringing your hands back. Exhale, round forward, bring your hands together. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, round your back, hands come close together. Last time. And release the hands. Shoulder rolls. Squeeze the shoulders up, squeeze them back, relax them down. Squeeze them up, squeeze them back, and relax them down. Couple more. Go forward, two. Beautiful work. For our next posture, I will show it two ways. It is a tricep stretch. So, if you do not have a yoga strap, follow me now. Take your right hand out to the side, bring your hand up overhead, and bring the hand to the back of your head or the back of your neck. Take your left hand and sweep it up too so that you can help your right elbow become more straight and feel some sensation from the tip of your elbow down into your armpit or your ribs. So that's a great way to do this stretch for your tricep. If you do have a yoga strap, I will have you wrap it around the back of your chair. Slide it to the right side of the chair. Sit back down in your chair in seated mountain pose. Reach for the back of your neck and feed that strap with your left hand into your right hand. Beautiful. So you're in the same stretch now. And to increase the stretch, lean away from the chair. Take a big breath wherever you are. And relax. Sitting back towards the back of the chair, you might feed the straps into the left hand and also allow the straps to slide to the left side of the chair, feeding your left hand a bit further down towards your shoulder and starting to lean away from the chair to feel the stretch more. If you do not have this strap, then what you can do is sweep your left hand up to the back of your head or neck and use your right hand as your assist, the good old-fashioned way. Wherever you are, close your eyes perhaps and take a breath or two. Beautiful. Release wherever you are. Bring your arms out to the side. The right palm, we want it to face up, the left palm down, and we're going to reach out to the right. You don't want your left sit bone to lift. Come on back to center, switch your palms and lean to the left. And slowly inhale, come back to center, release your arms. We're going to switch into our standing positions next. So take any props that you have around you and make sure that you're not going to step on them or trip over them. We'll come to standing and turn our chair in one direction. Now remember, some of this work might take a wall next to you for the extra balance. We're going to take our left foot and ground it down. So I'm going to step back just a little bit here and step my right foot up onto the chair. Remember, if you have a little bit of issue with balance on this side, maybe have a countertop, another chair handy, or a wall. From here, the hands can shift onto the knee. Stand up nice and tall, shoulders back, and begin to lunge. You should feel the stretch down the left calf and the strengthening happening in the right thigh. Some people can reach for the back of the chair. Some people will choose to have their hands on their thigh. Some people can bring their hands to their heart. And if you have fantastic balance, you can reach your hands out or even up overhead. Activate. Think about cinching the waistband, pulling the front aspect towards the back aspect, the sides together as you hold the posture, and we'll take one more breath. Let the left arm reach forward and the right arm reach back. You're in a twisted lunge or a twisted warrior here. One more breath. Hands sweep up to the knee. Remember to use your wall if you need to, and we'll step our right foot back down in alignment with the left. And we'll try it on the other side, stepping the left foot up onto the chair. You can keep a hand on the wall, a countertop, an extra chair next to you. If you would like, you can shift the hands to the top of the knee. Shoulders down, crown lifted. We'll begin to lunge, leaning into that posture. Three breaths here. Choose where you would like your hands to be, on the knee, on the chair, by your heart, or up overhead. Last breath. Right arm reaches forward, left arm reaches back into a twisted lunge. It's a high lunge, like a warrior. Last breath. It's getting burny, it's getting toasty in that leg. And we'll find our way back to center, use the wall for an assist, and step back down. Walk it out a little bit. All right, from here, I'm going to turn towards the wall so that I have the wall as my assist. So my right foot is now going to be grounded, and my left foot is going to step up onto the chair sideways. My foot is flat on the chair, my leg is straight, so that way I'm getting a nice stretch on the outer aspect of the leg, but I really do feel it on the inner as well. If you have good balance here, you can sweep your arms out to the side. If you need to, keep a hand on the wall or the counter or a chair in front of you. This left hand comes down onto the left leg, and we start to slide down. Maybe your right hand sweeps out and up to the ceiling. Whichever arm is not down on the leg, we want it to be expansive and reaching. And we'll fan ourselves back up. Hands come to the chair, the wall in front of you, and we'll step back down. And again, we'll turn the opposite direction. I'm going to pretend that I have a folding chair or another chair in front of me. And I'm going to ground down through my standing leg. Left leg on this side. Right foot up on the chair. I'm sorry if I had it backwards on the other side. So now I have my left leg grounded, right leg on the chair. I know it might look backwards in the video. And so from there, you can stay right here if you want to, if that's enough stretch for you. If you'd like to, you can tee your arms out to the side and come into a gate pose by dropping the right hand down onto the right leg. Left hand reaches up and maybe even over. We'll close our eyes and take a couple breaths, really challenging our balance here. Maybe one hand stays on the chair if you're having a little issue with balance today, or on this side. Really strengthening everything up here. Let's fan ourselves back up to center. And we'll grab onto the chair, the counter, or the wall and step down. Walk it out. Now we want to rotate our chair so that the seat is away from us for just a little bit of more balance work. So your fingertips can come onto the back of the chair. I'm going to tilt this up just a little so you can see me. Here we go. So we'll have, I'll come back to my left hand on the chair. My right knee bends. You can turn your knee out to the side, keep your toe on the floor if you'd like. Extra challenge would be foot around the calf muscle or foot in the inner thigh. You can bring that right hand straight out or to your heart center. And if it feels safe, you feel balanced here, you can test lifting your left hand away from the chair. Maybe the hand comes to heart center for tree pose, Vrikshasana. Take one more breath here, perhaps reaching your hands up past the head, over into the heavens, and then sweep the hands down, grab onto your chair, release your right foot down, and we'll switch sides. So now the chair is on the right side of the body. Left knee can bend. We'll turn the knee out to the side. This is the beginner posture. If you'd like to come into more of an intermediate challenge, the foot can wrap around the calf, or your foot can wrap around the inner thigh. Left hand to the center line of the body. And if you'd like an extra challenge, right hand can try to lift up away from the chair, maybe out to the side. Maybe it meets the left hand at heart center for a balance. Last breath with your inhale, sweep your hands through heart center, up through the crown, into the heavens, down and out to the side, grabbing onto the chair and releasing your left foot. Walk it out. Turn towards the back of your chair. Grab both hands onto the back of the chair. Begin to walk the feet back. Some people will get to this point. Some people can continue walking back. This is a chair downward dog. Bring your ears into alignment with your biceps. Start to take your tailbone and reach it up towards the sky so that your pelvis is anteriorly tilting or tilting forward. This will lengthen the backs of the legs. You might also feel this through your chest, through your shoulder blades. Look to the right, look to the left. And start to round up as you come into a standing position, walking towards your chair. We'll rotate our chair back ahead. Have a seat in your chair. In our seated mountain pose, this is our last posture for the day. We're going to take our right knee and step it out off the edge of the chair. And then we're going to take our left and kind of slide it out, but we want to rotate to the right. If it's possible for you, extend the left leg out. We're going to come into a warrior two, so my right foot is straight out off the right edge of the mat. The left leg is slightly in front of this front left curve of the chair. So it's right in front of it. Arms come up out to the side. So I'm in a warrior two, seated on a chair. Arms are going to be strengthened here, straight out to the side. So let's do that by making small circles going forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release them down. Come back to center, sliding your left foot forward, right foot forward. So now, our left foot is going to step directly off to the side of the left side of the chair. So my knee is settled right in this little cranny that the angle of the chair and the seat makes. The right foot is going to just extend out, and it's right in front of this curve of the right edge of the chair. So it's on the front aspect of the chair. I turn my toes down. Arms up out to the side. We're in warrior two on a chair. Arms are going to be strengthened by doing 5 backward circles. 3, 2, 1. You can do 5 more if you're not feeling much yet. 10 total maybe. And then we'll slowly come back to center. We'll take one more drape pose or dangling forward fold. Sweep your hands out, up, overhead. Inhale, exhale, over top your legs, letting your head round so that chin comes towards chest, hands towards the feet. Maybe they just dangle. Maybe it's better for you to have your feet wider so that you can come through the legs. It's your choice. Take one more breath wherever you are. Sweep your arms straight out. Use energy to pull yourself back up. Straighten yourself back out into a seated mountain pose. Release your hands onto the top of the thigh, or perhaps the palms face up. Relax your shoulders. Relax your jaw. Find your feet grounding into the floor. Your tailbone grounded into the chair. Your back, your ribs resting on the back of the chair, supported, held by the chair, by the earth. Bring your awareness back to your deep breathing. Breathing in through the nose and out through the nose, controlling the breath. Congratulations, you have completed this gentle chair yoga session with me today. I hope that you feel better now than you did when we first started, and that your body feels a little bit more open and free. Thank you so much for joining me this time. Namaste.